Om Sam Saraswati Namaha Namaste. Namaste, everyone. And on page 268, chapter 11, Ekadasho Dhyaya Dhyanam. Om Malara Bindu Tim Bindu Kiritam Tunga Kucham Nagatraya Nayutam Smeru Mukim Radan Kusha Pasha Viti Karam Rabate Bhuvane Sim Om Rishi Rubacham Divyaha Deta Pramaha Surindre Sendra Surabani Brook Bastam Katyaya Nindrushtu Barishta Lavaha Vikashi Bafrabja Vikashi Pasaha Devi Prabhanarthi Yare Prasivda Prasivda Mata Jagato Kilasya Prasivda Vishweshwari Pahati Vishwam Twamishwari Devi Characharasya Abdhan Rabhuta Jagatasvameka Magishwarupena Yatahastitasi Abham Swarupastita Yatayitat Tapyayate Krishna Balahya Virge Twam Vaishnavi Satiranamta Virya Vishwasya Vijam Paramasi Maya Samoitam Devi Samastamedat Tambai Prasna Bhuvi Mukti Retu Vidya Samasta Sama Devi Veda Sriya Samasta Sakala Jagatsu Tvayo Ikaya Purita Mamlitat Kati Stuti Stavya Praprotihi Sarva Bhutayata Devi Svarga Mukti Pradayini Tvam Suta Sutaya Kaba Bhavantu Paramotayaha Sarvashya Bhuti Rupena Janashya Riti Sanskrite Svarga Pavarga De Devi Narayani Namo Astute Kalakashtari Rupena Harinama Pradayini Vishwasyo Purto Shakti Narayani Namo Astute Sarva Mangala Mangalye Shive Sarvartha Sadhake Sharanya Grambake Gauri Narayani Namo Astute Srishti Sriti Vinasanam Sati Bhute Sanatani Gunashraye Dharmaye Narayani Namo Astute Sarnagata Dinaka Puritran Brahine Sarvashyati Are Devi Narayani Namo Astute Hamsa Yukta Vimanaste Ramani Rupa Darini Hosha Mahakshari Jai Devi Narayani Namo Astute Trisula Chandra Gidare Mahavrishava Bhagini Madheshwari Swarupena Narayani Namo Astute Mayura Kukurapite Mahashakti Dharenage Komari Rupa Samsane Narayani Namo Astute Shankar Chakra Gada Shankha Grihita Paramayude Prasidha Vaishnavi Rupe Narayani Namo Astute Grihito Mahra Mahatrapre Tamstro Dhrita Pasundare Varaha Rupini Shive Narayani Namo Astute Nrisinga Rupina Uprina Hantum Dvaityan Rito Dhyame Trilokya Trana Sakite Narayani Namo Astute Kiri Kini Mahapatre Sahasranayana Rojvule Ritra Pranahare Chandri Narayani Namo Astute Sivaduti Swarupena Hatadeta Mahavale Gora Rupe Maharade Narayani Namo Astute
Namaskar Prabhupada. Shiro Mala Bibhushane. Chamunde Mundamakane. Narayani Namavasute. Lakshmi Nate Mahavidye. Shade Pushti Shade Dube. Maharati Mahamade. Narayani Namavasute. Mede Saraswati Pare Bhuti. Babari Tamasi. Niyate Kwambasi Dei Sei. Narayani Namavasute. Sarvasvarupe Sarveshe. Sarva Shakti Samandite. Oyengas Kragi No Devi. Durge Devi Namavasute. Itati Bhaganam Samyam. Lochana Trayabhushitam. Patuna Asambiti Vyaka. Katriyayani Namavasute. Dwala Karala Madhyukra. Ashesha Sura Sudanam. Jisunam Batu no Dvitir, Bhadrakali Namavastute, Hinasti Daita Tidamsi, Swanina Puriyaya Jagat, Shaganta Batu no Devi, Pabhiryona Sukhadiva, Asura Sri Basa Pakacha, Chita Ste Karo Jvalaha, Shubhaya Karndo Bhadu Janite, Vandatavayam Rogana Sethana Bhanti Dushka Dushka Thukkaman Saklar Vishtam Tvama Shri Pranam Gripa Narandam Tvama Shri Kapyashraya Kamayanti Ethakritam Yathatnam Vayadyam Dharma Visham Devi Mahasuranam Rupayene Kriva Rudatma Murti Ripambike Kapakaroti Kanya Vidyasu Kafeshu Viveka Vitesh Padyeshu Bhakyeshu Chakarpadanya Mamakrate Gati Mahandakare Vipramatyatri Tatati Vavishwam Rachan Siya Trongrabi Shashkadana Yatra Rayoga Shumalani Yatra Dabanalong yatra tathati matye Tratrasi tarvam nipasi viswam Ishweshwari tvam nipasi viswam Ishwarnika dara yasiti viswam Ishwetamanya bhavati bhavanti Vishwashraya yitvahi bhakti namraha Devi prasiv da pripalaya nori ter Nityam yatasura vadadadu naivya sadhya Pāpāni sarva-jagatam prashmanayasu Upāpa-pāpa-jali-dhangas-chapa-kopa-sārkam Pranātana-nāṁ-kasīda-tvam Devi-viśvārti-hārini Trinukya-vasana-mītye Lokāmāṁ-pradāpava
Turn to page 268 and we'll translate the Narayani Stuti. Nara means humanity. It also means mankind. It means a man. And Narayani, who has the ayan of Nara, the eyes of humanity, the perception of humanity in the female. Narayani is the exposer of consciousness. Because she makes the consciousness perceivable. She gives it a form. Just like the great limitation of consciousness, Mahamaya. She limits the consciousness by creating a form of consciousness, a container for the consciousness, so that we can perceive an individual form as opposed to formlessness. Infinite consciousness without obstruction, without limitation. So Narayani is the exposer of consciousness. She is the eyes of humanity. She's the eyes of all beings. She is the perceiver, the, pers- the she energizes the Narayana, the Supreme Consciousness, as he perceives infinitely. Chapter 11, let's read her meditation. I meditate up on the goddess Bhuvaneshwari, the ruler of the earth. The brilliancy of her body is like sunrise in the morning. The moon is a crown upon her head. Her swelling breasts overflow and her three eyes are in union. Remember, with her left breast she feeds us devotion. With the right breast she gives us wisdom. And her blessed breasts are overflowing with wisdom and devotion. She's nurturing her children, just like every one of you, the mothers that I know. They nurture their children so they'll become filled with devotion and wisdom. Her three eyes are in union, and that means the sun, the moon, the fire, and she is just in perfect harmony, in perfect balance, in perfect union. The three gunas, sattva, raja, tama, the three goddesses, Anirin, Klima, Kalima, Lakshmima, Saraswati, the three devas, all the threes are in perfect union and harmony. Upon her face shines her radiant smile. Always tushti rupena samstita. She's always content and always satisfied. And her hands show the mudras granting boons, the curved sword, the net, and the mudra granting fearlessness. Avoy. Bordan, avoy. Giving boons and freedom from fear. And the rishi said, Om. When the great lord of thought was slain by the goddess, the gods, with the rule of the pure, led by the light of meditation, illuminating the quarters with their cheerful faces because of the fulfillment of their desire, praise the ever pure one. So remember now here, the great lord of thought, the Shum, he's the self-conceit and self-deprecation, along with their extensive armies. They were all slain by the goddess. All the gods wanted to do was sing our thanks as a song of thanksgiving. Thanks a lot, Mom. So the rule of the pure, the ruler of all purity, gathered up all the other pure qualities within us because all the negativities had been disposed of. They fled to a distance, led by the light of meditation. Because when we sang this song, we were filled with purity and the joy and the bliss, the light of meditation, the light of purity, the focus that's Agni, illuminating the quarters with their cheerful faces. I mean, everybody was really happy. Because our desire was fulfilled. Self-conceit, self-deprecation, and they met their demise at the hands of the goddess. She withdrew her energy from them. And that was it. And she is the ever pure one. O goddess, you who remove the distress of all who take refuge in you, be pleased. That's us. Please, be pleased with us. We're taking refuge in you. Be pleased, O mother of the entire perceivable universe, the entire perceivable world. That means all manifested existence. Be pleased, O supreme of the universe. Protect the universe, O goddess. You are supreme over all that moves and does not move. Chara achar. Whether it moves or it doesn't move, animate or inanimate, it doesn't matter. You are the supreme consciousness within all. Whether it moves or it doesn't move. You're the god of everything. Because you exist as the intrinsic nature of the earth, you alone are the sole support of the material world. You shitty uptage mortal bone. You are the five elements. You are in the intrinsic nature of earth. You alone are the sole support that is all manifested existence, has its existence within you. O goddess of unchallengeable valor. You reside as the intrinsic nature of water in the form of its container, always in balance, in perfect equilibrium, always seeking its own level and nourishing and lubricating whereby you gratify this all. All of it. You just gratify it all. You are the energy of the consciousness that pervades all. Of infinite valor. That means you're a good fighter. You just take away the energy from any opponent. Done! Infinite valor, the seed of the universe. You are the bij. You are the bindu. You are the first spark of manifested existence. That which is beyond limitation. By you, O goddess, all is deluded by attachment. And if you are gracious, you are the cause of liberation in this world. So as the Maya of Shankya, where you are the illusion which obscures the reality, you cause all of us to be deluded by attachment. I and mine, self-conceit and self-deprecation, too much and too little, etc., etc. And if you are gracious when you're happy with us, when you give us your grace, and remember that grace is kripa, and the kri means do and pa means get. When you give us that do and get, you are the cause of liberation in this world. We are free when we're with you. There's no other place to be. Oh goddess, all that is knowable are your various distinctions. That means everything that we know is another form of you. It's an individual form of you. It's a distinct form of you. And all women in the world reflect your capacity entirely. Please remember that, ladies. All women in the world reflect your capacity entirely. Hey, gentlemen, you better remember too. Because they're all divine mothers and they're all representatives of the divine mother. And if they're not divine in your eyes, then you have to become Shiva and make them divine. By you, O Mother, this world is filled. For you who are beyond praise, how can we sing your glory? O Goddess, bestower of heaven and liberation, you are all existence. That's pretty big. When you have been thus extolled, what else can be sung of your glory? Remember, Brahma and Vishnu and Shiva were incapable extolling the infinity of attributes of the Divine Mother. What else shall we say? You reside in the hearts of all living beings in the form of intelligence. You bestow upon your devotees heaven and liberation. O goddess, exposer of consciousness, we bow to. Well, here you are in the heart of all living beings, no, in the form of Jnana Shakti, in the form of Buddhi. And we know you are the energy of all knowledge. Icha Kriya Jnana Shakti reside in every atom of existence, from Brahma to a blade of grass. You are the intelligence, the intrinsic nature of intelligence, exposer of consciousness. We bow down to you. In the form of divisions of time, you bring about change. And all of the goddesses hold that chakra, Sudarshan chakra, the discus of revolving time, which gives us infinite patience. And we understand it's going to take some time to bring about this change, and all the changes occur in the perception of time to the energy that exists after the dissolution of the universe. That is all potential energy. There is no kinetic energy. It is Baha Praloy. There is no dvitiyam, no duality. Dvitiyam namaha para, exposer of consciousness, Narayani, we bow to you. To the auspicious of all auspiciousness, to the good, to the accomplisher of all objectives, to the source of refuge, to the mother of the three worlds, to the goddess who is rays of light, exposer of consciousness, we bow to.
You are the eternal energy of creation, preservation, and destruction in all existence. That upon which all qualities depend, that which limits all qualities. Exposer of consciousness, we bow to you. You are Srishti, Sthiti, and Mahapralay. You are all the gunas reside in you and they depend upon you. You are the substratum from all qualities and you are the limitation of all qualities. You define all qualities. We bow to you. This is really important. To those who are devoted to you and take refuge in you, even though lowly and humble, you save them from all discomfort and unhappiness. Now, if we can be devoted to you and take refuge in you, we're lowly and humble because we're taking refuge in you. That's the sign of our humility. Then you take away all discomfort and all unhappiness because we become full of devotion. All worry you take away, O goddess, exposer of consciousness, we bow to you. Wearing the form of creative energy, sitting upon the carrier, yoked to the swans of vital breath, remember the Hamsayukta Biman, the Biman, the carrier, the conveyance, which is yuked, united with, or pulled by the swans, the hamsa, the swans of pranayam. You are sprinkling water with the sanctity of kusha grass. Remember abhishek, where your kodache, you did abhishek, O goddess, exposer of consciousness. We bow to you. In the form of the energy of the great seer of all, Maheshwari, displaying the trident of unity, the moon of devotion, and the serpents of energy, just like Shiva, just like Mahadev, mounted upon the great bull of Rishabhrurha, of discipline, exposer of consciousness, we bow to you. Appearing in the form of the ever-pure one as Kumari, accompanied by the cock of regularity and the peacock of beauty, wielding the great energy, sinless exposer of consciousness, we bow to you. Be gracious in the form of the energy of the consciousness that pervades all Vaishnavi. You who bear the conch of vibrations, the discus of revolving time, the club of articulation, and the bow of determination, exposer of consciousness, we bow to you. In the form of the most excellent desire of union, Varahi, you raise the earth with your tusks of perseverance. Wielding the great discus of revolving time for the good, exposer of consciousness, we bow to you. In the form of the man lion of courage, courageous fortitude, Narsingh, Nrisimhi, you engaged in slaying thoughts, protecting the three worlds, exposer of consciousness, we bow to you. Now remember, in chapter 8, when all the goddesses came, and they all came in the same form as the god from who sent them, as the form, the male form of consciousness who presided over that attribute, the goddesses came to fight in the battle with the Asuras. And in any way that the gods appeared, In that same appearance came the goddesses, with the same vehicle, the same carrier, the same weapons, the same attributes, the same capability of destroying the negativities of egotism. Possessing a crown, the great thunderbolt of illumination, and 1,000 radiant light eyes, Indrani, taking the life from confusion, exposer of consciousness, we bow to you. The intrinsic nature of he for whom consciousness is emissary. Remember, Shivaduti, Chandi became Shiva, Kali became Shivaduti when she sent Shiva to the Asuras. And she was called the chi for whom consciousness is emissary, who conquered the mighty armies of thought, a fearful form, an intense sound. Remember, she slapped the earth, and her slap, it overpowered all the other sounds. Exposer of consciousness, we bow to you. With great teeth in your mouth, displaying a garland of heads of evil thoughts, O slayer of passion and anger, Chanda, exposer of consciousness, we bow to you. Remember, she took the heads of anger and passion. She said, I present to you two great beasts. Now you yourself will slay Shub and Nishum. We bow to you. To the true wealth, Lakshmi. The goal, Lakshya, Lakshmi Lajay, humility, Mahavidyay, great knowledge, Shraddha, Pushti, great faith and nourishment, Shwade, Dhruve, self-sustenance, constancy, the great night of ignorance and the great measurement of consciousness, exposer of consciousness, we bow to you. The intellect of love, the spirit of all-pervading knowledge, the best. All existence, nature, unknowable one, fully occupied with self-restraint. O Supreme, be pleased, exposer of consciousness, we bow to you. The intrinsic nature of all, the supreme of all, the energy of all as well. You remove all fear from us, O Goddess, reliever of difficulties. O Goddess, we bow to you. And we bow to you, remember, with namaste, namostute, with all the energy of my conscious being. We bow to the divinity which you reflect me from in my heart. O Goddess, reliever of difficulties, O Goddess, we bow to you. May this beautiful face, displaying three eyes, protect us from all existence, ever pure one, Katyayani, we bow to you. With intensive brilliance, exceedingly sharp, the fierce destroyer of all thoughts, may your trident protect us from all fear. O excellent she who is beyond time, Bhadrakali, we bow to you. Remember, the trident is the unity of all the threes. That's her weapon. And she is Bhadrakali, the holder of the trident. The excellent she who is beyond all time, or she who takes away the darkness. O Goddess, the loud sound of your bell fills the perceivable world, destroying the prowess of all thoughts and protecting us from evil as a mother protects her children. Remember when that sound, that continuous vibration, the ringing of the bell comes into our ears, all the thoughts are stunned. And the bell is protecting us just as a mother is protecting her children. May the brilliant sword of worship in your hands, smeared with the blood and fat of thoughts, act for our welfare. O you thought, we bow down to you. When you are pleased, you destroy all infirmities. Please, everybody mark this verse. If anyone is ill, if anyone is suffering from any infirmity, you can make japa a recitation of this verse. When you are pleased, you destroy all infirmities. And when you are displeased, you frustrate all desires. No calamity befalls those who take refuge in you, and those who take refuge in you invariably become a refuge to others. Invariably. Some of us sooner, and some of us later. Invariably, we become a refuge to others. Who else could do this that you have now performed, slaughtering the great thoughts, the enemies of the way of truth to wisdom? They were obstructors of Dharma. They were enemies of this way of perfection. They are way enemies obstructing the ideals of perfection by manifesting the one form of the mother of the universe into many. And that's just how you did it. Now we see you everywhere, in every form. You are one, and now we see you in every form. Who other than you is spoken of in knowledge, in scriptures, in discourses, in all sound as the light of discrimination? You are the light of discrimination that has been expounded and propounded in all knowledge, in all scriptures, in all sound. You throw the universe into the great blinding darkness of egotism and attachment and make it whirl. It's your energy, Mom. You make us forget that you are here, and then you're gracious and you remind us, hey kids, don't forget your mother. Where there are demons of confused thoughts, serpents of dreadful poison, where there are foes and mighty hosts of robbers, where there is a great conflagration, in the midst of the sea of objects and their relationships, you stand and save the universe. Here we are in the midst of this ocean of objects and relationships, the sansa, and here you are standing up right in the middle of it, and you're here to save the universe. You are the sovereign of the universe. You protect the universe, the soul of the universe. You support the universe. Those who bow to you with devotion become the refuge of the universe. Na samshaya, without a doubt, anyone who takes refuge in you invariably becomes a refuge to others. Oh goddess, please be pleased. As you have just now saved us by slaying thoughts, in like manner always save us from fear of foes. Eradicate all evil from all the worlds, as well as all confusion and disturbance. Please, Mother. Please eradicate all evil from all the worlds and all the confusion and all the disturbances. Please. Oh goddess, remover of the sufferings and calamities of the universe, be gracious to us who bow down to you. You be gracious to us who bow down to you. To you who are worthy of praise by the inhabitants of the three worlds, grant the best to all worlds. Please, that's our prayer to you, Mother. Just remove all confusion, all ego, all evil, all disturbances, and grant the best to all the worlds. Narayani, namaste. Let's see if there are any questions about the Narayani Stuti. What would the gods want to say to the goddess after all their negativities have been destroyed? Yes, please.
Swamiji, in this chapter and in chapter 4 as well, the meter, the chanda, switches from ushnik to anushtub.
Yes, from anushtub to trishtub.
Trishtub. And
and back again.
Yes. What is the objective for that switch? Did the poet have a specific objective for changing the chanda?
Yes. Anushtub is a chanda of narration, and trishtub is a chanda of praise. So you'll find many, many hymns of praise written in trishtub chanda, many, many narratives conducted in anushtub chanda. Although you can conduct praise in any chanda, but primarily the change in the chanda indicates that we're moving from a narration of what's taking place right now to our song of devotion.
Swamiji, are all the verses from the first verse to verse 35 part of Narayani Stuti?
Yes. Yes, the entire, all the way to verse 35 is Narayani Stuti. And it's the Stuti, the song of praise to the goddess Narayani. We bow down to you.
Swamiji, in verse 8 it says, Sarvasya buddhi rupena janasya kriti sanskrite. What is the relationship between the heart and intelligence?
We know in our heart. And then it's sincere. We know in our mind, and it's a passing thought. We may act on it or we may not act on it, but when we know in our heart it's correct, then response is natural. It's swabhavik. There's a natural change in our behavior because of the knowing in our heart, as opposed or compared or contrasted with knowing in our mind. We know many intellectual facts in our minds. They don't necessarily change our behavior. But when we know it in our heart, our behavior is changed automatically without our even thinking about it. Yes, Mother is saying that when we have intelligence in the heart, it is the intelligence, the intellect of love.
Swamiji, question from Devi from Atlanta.
Namaste, Devi Ma.
She's asking about verse 6, where it says women reflect the qualities of Divine Mother.
Absolutely.
She's saying, I assume the opposite is also true, that if the man doesn't reflect Shiva, that the woman can help him best by reflecting Divine Mother, so he will see Shiva in himself. Is it correct to assume that our practice, the wife's practice, is the best way to bring this reflection to its brightness? Can you talk about this more, please?
Yes, certainly, Devi. Devi Ma, I love the verse from Lalita Trishati that says Shiva and Shakti revolve around each other mutually and reciprocally. Who understands this understands what is a center of energy. Now here it's the verse is saying to the mother of the universe, all women in the world reflect your capacity entirely. That is, if you are the Divine Mother, you will inspire your Shiva to actually act like Shiva. And if he is actually Shiva, he will regard his Shakti as the Divine Mother. And that is the relationship between the two. And that's the purpose of the marriage. Marriage is a contract to serve as a constant reminder to our spouse and partners that you are divine. You are the Divine Mother. And that's the only way I can realize myself as Shiva, is to be living with Shakti. And the only way she could realize she is the Divine Mother is to have Shiva as a spouse.
So this verse is saying that all women in the world reflect her capacity entirely, and it's true, because Shakti is the energy of inspiration, and a good woman, Patni Manoramandethi Manoritam Tarinim, Tarinim Durga Sansara Sagarasyatulogaban. Give me the Shakti, give me the wife, the inspiration to lead me and my good family across this difficult ocean of samsara. This ocean of confusion, let me go pass over this ocean of confusion by the inspiration of Shakti. So all women in the world reflect this capacity, this divine capacity entirely. It's her inspiration which will make a man divine, and it's his understanding which will keep her inspiration flowing.
Samji Kumari from Valley Home.
Namaste, Kumari Ma.
She's saying in verse 6, if it's true that all women in the world reflect your capacity entirely, then why don't we see this perfection in all women?
Well, how many of these women are studying the Chandi? If they would read the Chandipat, they would read that they are reflections of the Divine Mother, and they have a divine duty and a divine right to act in accordance with that divinity. They should be inspiring wherever they go instead of being caught up in pettiness, in self-conceit and self-deprecation. So those women who study the Chandi and do the sadhana of the Chandi remind themselves daily that I am the part of the Divine Mother, and I reflect her capacity entirely.
Question from Morning Song from Santa Rosa.
Namaste, Morning Song.
Namaste, Swamiji. What does it mean to become a refuge to others? Thank you.
In any way that you become a refuge, just to be a good friend, just to be a good listener, just to give inspiration, just to be a model or an example of truth, somebody who is pursuing their sadhana, somebody who is teaching, somebody who is giving inspiration and knowledge, these are all forms of refuge. And so when you become a refuge to others, you take the knowledge of the Chandi and pass it on, either through your words or through your deeds.
Swamiji, question from Ambika from New Jersey.
Namaste, Ambika.
Pranam mine, Swamiji. In verse 29, is there a way to sense whether mother is frustrating our desires because she is displeased, or if the difficulty is our tapasya and we have to push through it? Thank you.
Ambika, we obviously have to push through. There's no circumstance where we can just quit and say, hey, I won't go any further. But she's frustrating our desires because she's displeased, and she may be displeased because it's an inappropriate desire, or she may be displeased because we're not producing the right effort in order to fulfill that desire. In either case, she may be displeased. So those are two examples of her displeasure. Hey, you chose the wrong thing and I'm not pleased with that. I don't want to give it to you. Be careful what you wish for, you may get it. So she may be displeased because your effort isn't pure. You're only putting forth a small effort, and this desire, the fulfillment of this desire requires a great effort.
Swamiji, question from Janitri from Reston.
Namaste, Janitri.
Does a devotee remain quiet when he or she has sickness, or is it good for him or her to be humble and ask Divine Mother for help with the infirmity after doing japa and chanting?
Oh, Janitri, it is never inappropriate to ask the Divine Mother for anything that you need. You have the infirmity and it becomes an obstruction to your sadhana. Now, Mother, please allow me to give you greater devotion by removing my infirmities so that I don't have any obstructions to my sadhana. In fact, my ignorance is also an infirmity. My lack of devotion is also an infirmity. And anything that makes me incapable of giving 101% is an infirmity. And I want to give more. So please, Mother, assist me by removing these infirmities, whether they be physical or mental or psychic or psychological or any other kind. Remove all infirmities, please. It's not an inappropriate prayer.
Question from Neelima from New Delhi.
Namaste, Neelima.
Namaste, Maa and Swamiji. When reciting the part, the heart is overwhelmed with bhakti and the head is not really registering the meaning of the words being uttered. Is it really the verses of the Chandi part or only a perception? Thank you.
Oh, Neelima, it's both. It is both. And when we got through reciting the part which was filling our hearts, we came back and read the meaning which is filling our minds. And now when we read it and we think about what it means and what we are saying, oh, I'm bowing to you. I bow to you with devotion because you are giving us this treasure of inspiration and devotion through which we can eliminate all of our iniquities. All of our shortcomings become offerings into the fire. All the negativities. So it's not just blind faith. It's not just the expression of devotion, but it's the expression of devotion with knowledge and understanding, the application of this truth to the circumstances of our lives. And that's called wisdom. It's not one, or not the other. It's all. It's holistic spirituality. This is a holistic offering from the heart, with intelligence, with understanding and knowledge. What it means and how to use it, and how does it change my life because of that knowledge? Every one of us will answer that question through our own experiences.
Swamiji, a question from Usha from Canada.
Namaste, Usha Ma.
Pranam, Swamiji. Here the three eyes of the goddess are described as being in union, sun, moon and fire. I assume the sun, moon would be Shiva Shakti in union. Is the fire symbolic of divine passion or purification?
Both. And the fire is also Kundalini. So it's the light of the Shiva Shakti and the Kundalini, which is the individual energy, is rising up and illuminating all of my life, my Shiva and my Shakti. So that's why she has the three eyes of the sun and moon and fire, and the three lights. The light of wisdom is the sun, the light of devotion is the moon, and the light of purification, the light of meditation is the fire. So here we're meditating on the light of wisdom and devotion and the purification of the three. This is how we perceive the three eyes. These are our perceiving apparatus.
Swamiji, question from Dan from New Jersey.
Namaste, Dan.
Swamiji, Dan wants to know which text historically came first, the Devi Gita or Devi Mahatmya?
Devi Mahatmya. The Chandi Path is Devi Mahatmya. The Durga Shaptashati has three names for the same text. Came from Markandeya Purana, which is the first of all of the Puranas. The Devi Gita, it comes later. The Devi Gita actually comes from the Srimad Devi Bhagavatam, which is much later, about 1,000 years later. 900 to 1,000 years later.
Swamiji, Dan has another question from chapter 7.
Yes, please.
It's verses 20, 21 of chapter 7.
Okay.
And he says that Durga actually slayed the Asuras, Chanda and Munda, And Kali did not actually slay them, but only brought Durga the heads of these asuras. Is that true?
Yes, it is true. Actually, they're one and the same. The remover of darkness, Kali, took the heads of passion and anger. They're one and the same here. The goddess was seated upon a lion. The remover of darkness, that's Kali, she laughed furiously, her teeth radiantly gleaming in her fierce mouth. Then the goddess, mounting upon the lion, seized passion by the hair and cut off his head. So I assume that they're still talking about Kali here. But Kali, in the form of Chamunda, sat upon the lion. So it's not... There's only one goddess. There's only one god. Remember when she, in chapter 10, she withdrew all her energies and all of the goddesses went marching right into her, the center of her being, and dissolved into oneness. And she said, that I am the only one here, and there is not a second. So it really doesn't matter if we are calling her the reliever of difficulties or the remover of darkness. For me, it's the same. If I can give up all my difficulties, I'll be satisfied. Or if I give up all my darkness, I won't have any difficulties anymore.
Swamiji, question from Nanda from San Jose.
Namaste, Nanda. I hope you're feeling better.
He's saying, Pranam Swamiji, pardon me, but are not the Shama Prarthana prayers from the Chandi and Adi Shankaracharya very much in the style of self-deprecation?
No, absolutely not. They are in the style of humility, not in the style of self-deprecation. Self-deprecation is saying, poor me. I'm not good enough. And humility says, look, Mom, I just recited to you 700 verses, and I really don't understand fully what they're saying. Give me greater understanding, give me greater meaning. I don't know the proper ways of worship. I don't know the proper ways of uniting with you. Please, excuse me, forgive me for all my shortcomings. I don't think that's self-deprecation, Nanda. I would say that is humility. And the difference between self-deprecation and humility, for me, is that self-deprecation, I beat myself and I despise myself, I put myself down. And I really feel inferior. Whereas humility, I humble myself before you and I plead with you, I beg to you, make me better, Mom. Please, excuse me for my shortcomings, make me better. So self-deprecation pushes me down and holds me down. And humility, I push myself down and so that she can raise me up.
Swamiji, in verse 25,
yes, please.
It says, may this beautiful face displaying three eyes protect us from all existence. Why do we want protection from all existence?
Because every object of existence has the capacity to capture my attention, captivate my perceiving capacity, and thrust me into the whirlpool of desire. It can create attachment. Any object of creation. Even I can become attached to a water pot, or to the coconut, or to a book. I can become attached to so many things. Please protect me from everything. May I cultivate the right attachments? May I give proper attention in appropriate circumstances? So for this reason, in this way, we're requesting, please, Mom, save us from everything. It's all you, we know that. Let us gravitate towards the appropriate forms of you and abstain from the ten gentle forms. Om Sam Saraswati Namaha.